हाई एवरीवन, यू आर वेलकम टू माय प्रोफेसर नोट. सो इस वीडियो में हम बात करेंगे दैट हाउ विद इन दीज रिमेनिंग डेज, जो हमारे पास दिन बचे हैं 10 से 15 दिन, इनके बीच हम क्या स्ट्रेटजीज यूज कर सकते हैं, क्या क्या हम अपनी प्रेपरेशन में ऐसे कुछ टेक्निक्स ला सकते हैं जिससे हम मैक्सिमम स्कोर कर सकते हैं और अपना नेट क्वालिफाई कर सकते हैं वेरी इजीली. Easily means it can be done, so it's easy, but the process will be really hard. You really have to grind yourself for 10 to 12 hours a day, right? If you are ready for that, let's start the video. सबसे पहले आपका paper 1 है, and whatever I am sharing with you, that is based on the experience. Every single strategy and technique have a logic behind this. Now who I am? Here is my scorecard. I have qualified my net with 99.32 percentile, and now I'm here to help you guys in your journey to qualify net now. आपका जो paper 1 है, सबसे पहले उसके बारे में बात करते हैं. आपके पास all 10 units है, ठीक है, and you are somebody who not even have touched any of these units, or maybe आपने touch किया है but most of the concepts आपके लिए clear नहीं है, and that is the reason you are watching this video, ठीक है. सबसे बेस्ट स्ट्रेटजी ये है, स्टार्ट गिविंग मॉक्स. सिंपली जस्ट डू दैट, स्टार्ट गिविंग योर मॉक्स. वट एवर नॉलेज यू हैव राइट नाउ ना, ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दैट स्टार्ट गिविंग योर मॉक टेस्ट्स, एंड यू विल फाइंड अ ह्यूज चेंज फ्रॉम दिस फर्स्ट मॉक टिल द योर 10th मॉक. दिस जर्नी विल बी इनक्रेडिबल. इट विल टीच यू अलॉट. मे बी इन योर फर्स्ट मॉक यू कैन स्कोर लेस देन 40 और मोर देन 40, But your next mock, in your next mock you will be scoring more than that. You will go under depression when you will find that you are not able to score good. और ये चीज़ें होती हैं. And this journey will teach you that how to take that pain, how to go through suffering. And this is important. It's going to be a great journey, I'm telling you. So just simply start giving your mock, right? Or एक चीज़ है, आपका माइंडसेट भी है. अगर आप माइंडसेट में हमेशा मना ही अपने आप को करते रहेंगे कि मैं नहीं कर सकता, बस इतना दिन है, देयर आर अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल हु हैव टेकन लाइक मंथ्स एंड इयर्स, उनका नहीं हुआ तो हाउ कैन आई डू दैट. यू, इट्स ऑल अबाउट योर माइंडसेट, द वे यू थिंक, द वे यू बिकम. अपना पूरा एनर्जी लगा दीजिए, वट एवर टाइम यू हैव लेफ्ट, यू कैन डू इट. दैट इज for sure that even you can qualify it, right? That is my guarantee to you. If you just put every single thing into it, na, net will be yours. Nothing is impossible, right? So if we talk about now all these 10 units, that how we can deal with them separately. Your first unit, which is your teaching aptitude, 2 to 3 questions based on a very common sense, right? They are asking questions like that, how is the mentality and the psychology of a teacher when he is into the classroom or she is in the classroom? How do you treat if there is a student sitting who is physically challenged? How will you deal with him? So such a practical questions are being asked. Then your communication. In your communication, you have questions like, again, on a very practical basis, but some of them on the basis of your technical terms, which is again in your teaching aptitude and very much into your research aptitude. In your communication, like what is your phatic communication, in your research aptitude, it's all about your null hypothesis, your alternative hypothesis, your deductive, your inductive, right? All these things are there, and you need to have a good knowledge about them. Research aptitude is more about clearing your concept, as your Indian logic is. Indian logic is not for mugging things up. This thing is to understand the topic, that what are the pramanas, what is a vyapati, you know, what is the inference and how these things work, what is induction, what is deduction. All these things again are there. Your logical reasoning. And I am one thing for sure, if your maths is good. In maths, your ratio, your percentage, your loss and profit. In your DI, if your ratio and percentage is good, it's 10 marks right there. Because as I have seen this very closely, this trend from past few years or even before that, they are asking questions just on the basis of ratio and percentage in DI. All right. If you can clear 2 to 3 concepts, ratio, percentage, profit and loss, you will get it. Your higher education and people and environment. Most of the questions based on your very current affairs, like NIRF list has been released, your world university list has been released. I have a channel, My Professor Note, NTA UGC Net for Paper 1 on Telegram, you will find it. There I am sharing every single day quizzes and your latest current affair related to these both of these units and the other units, like the most important concepts. So make sure you go there and join it. Very recently I have opened it. So, but there I have shared all these current affairs related to the people and environment and the higher education, and it will help you immensely. So make sure you join it. All right. And now, what else we have now? Your ICT. In ICT, they are again and again asking the same questions, like your email, right? Your, what is your memory, your small memory and your biggest memory space, right? These are the questions they are asking. What is your browser? Your very latest softwares, this is what they are asking. So what you have to do is just simply go on a Google and just find out this list of 50 to 100 most important ICT questions, right? They are always the same. That will help you. And your PYQs, whatever question related to ICTs are there. So you just simply do them, right? So now your all these units almost we have covered. And if I come to the conclusion of all these for paper one, simply whatever knowledge you have right now on the basis of that, give a mock. You will get it. Your journey from the first mock to your 10th mock will be incredible. You will go through hardships. You will go through a lot of struggle in your mind when you will find that you are not even scoring a plus 40. But your next mock, which you will give after revising and analyzing your first mock, that will be more than your previous score that you have scored. So this is about the paper one. Let's talk about now paper two. And here specifically, I'll be talking for English literature students. What you can do is, here you have 10 units. Again, you write them all down and just tick it, tick it, tick it, that how many units are clear for you, right? British, your literature, most important concept that you already know. Your first four units now, your prose, your drama, your poetry, your novel, you just put them under the British literature only, right? And now how to cover them? Now there are two ways for that. What is the way? You can simply read your English literature Wikipedia page. There will be just all these ages are covered in a chronological manner, right? What are the important prose they have mentioned there? What are the important novels they have? Like each and every single age, in Jacobean age, which dramas were important? They have the very important dramas they have mentioned there. You can go through this one approach. Second is your PYQPs, the approach which I had adopted. What you have to do is go through all the PYQPs from 2004 to 2020, because I think before 2004 they were paper was, I think it was a written based paper. After that we started to get these MCQs. So you go through all the topics which are asked there in the question and as the option. For example, they're asking question that which book is written by this particular writer, right? So now the question is about writer. So make sure you read about the writer, his Wikipedia page, his info, his works, his criticism, and how he's been interpreted by the other critiques, and his important works. Now you have given the four options that which novel, right? They may also have included other writers' novel there just to confuse you a bit. Make sure you read all those novels as well, all those options as well. You have to do the same thing with all the questions. This is what I have done. This is a very laborious task, and it will take a grind of 10 to 12 hours a day, right? It will take that much, and it cannot be completed within this period of time, but it depends person to person. You are taking shortcuts. Okay, this one here. All right, your work of guessing. But if you don't want to go through this process because it will take a lot of time, you can simply go from my notes, which is my professor updated detailed notes, which I am providing to you. And if you want to get access to them, you can just simply contact me on the contact number which I have given below in the description box, right? Here I have completed all the 10 latest pattern units within the 16 files. Each and every single thing, it's just very clear. in a crisp and precise manner, I'm sharing it, right, in these notes. So you can get access to them. All you have to do is just let me know. You can contact me on the contact number which I have given below here. But if you are somebody ziddi kind of person like me, that nahin mujhe khud hi karna hai, but within these 10 to 15 days, it's really hard, surely I would say. But as much as you can do, you do it. Go for important novels only. Go for important your poetry works. And how? Just simply type on Google important prose works of British literature. Important poetry works of British literature. Right? Search each and every single thing on Google. Google will give you all the answers. Right? Whatever question you ask me, I ask them Google. And then I come back to you to elaborate it in a more lucid manner. Now you know that 100 questions, your 100 marks are just being asked from your British literature. The remaining units, which is your language and linguistics. In language and your linguistics, the very, very basics of linguistics, its elements, like the study of words, morphology, the study of your sounds, your phonetics, all this must be clear to you. Your Noam Chomsky, very important. Your Saussure is very important. B.F. Skinner, important. Your Sapir hypothesis, really important. You have your literary theory, your postmodernism, your postcolonialism, your structuralism, post-structuralism, deconstruction, feminism, Marxism, must be clear to you, right? All the important writers related to it, all the important theorists related to it, all the important terms related to it, right? Your criticism, Plato to T.S. Eliot. If you have your notes ready, this is well and good. If you don't have, you can refer to my notes, right? English in India. English in India, I'm saying this is a very, very small topic here. But from last the 2 to 3 years since they have added this unit here in the paper, they're asking almost 5 to 6 questions every single year. And it becomes really important, so I don't want you to miss on it. So make sure these 4 to 5 topics which I have shared with you, British literature, theory, linguistics and language, your criticism, English, India, this is really important. And now here I'm skipping because it's a research method and the culture studies. Look, your culture study is interdisciplinary. So interdisciplinary means it's already dependent on the other fields, right? It's drawing knowledge from the other theories here, like your post-structuralism, your structuralism, post-colonialism, modernism, feminism, Marxism, because it understands the culture, it reads the culture, its development. And for reading that, understanding it, to bringing the meaning out of it, you have to adopt the approaches of post-structuralism, to understand the struggle between classes and society and the family and between men and women. You have to understand the Marxism and feminism. Right. So while you are covering your theory section, you are already covering your culture studies as well. Okay. So this is my approach. And if I just conclude this whole video, for paper one, whatever knowledge you right now have, on the basis of that knowledge, start giving your mock test. Right. Just simply do that. If you are someone who has not even touched the book or concepts not that much clear, even you will be able to score good. You will qualify, right? In the paper one, 60 plus, I am telling you. If your DI is good, it's 10 marks right there. For environment, your higher education, I'm telling you current affairs, which I have shared on my Telegram channel. Your communication, teaching aptitude, very, very common sense based question, two to three questions, right? Your comprehension. Nobody prepared for this concept. We all just directly go to the examination room and just we attempt it. So it's all easy. ICT, they are repetitively asking same those questions on the basis of memory and all. So you can do it. You can score 60 plus very easily here. If you are really someone who are preparing from a really long time, so you can score more than 80 plus. For your paper two, PYQPs plays the most important role. You can simply go for my professor note, my contact below in the description box. So you can join my Telegram channel where I'm sharing quizzes, notes, and all the important details to make you qualify this exam, right? If there's anything else you want me to help you out, please let me know below in the comment section. So keep preparing, give your 100%. Till then time, my professor note, signing off.